Hi everyone, welcome to Pulse of the Port. I'm your host, Sean Horish. As you can see behind me, it takes a lot of mechanized muscle to move countless containers coming in and out of SSA Terminal's Pier A facility. What you may not know is that SSA owns its own equipment and has an on-site maintenance division to keep it all running smoothly. Before we check out that operation, let's take a look at how the Port of Long Beach's use of shore power to reduce vessel emissions is helping them stay ahead of the environmental curve.
California has a new state regulation that will affect the Port of Long Beach effective January 1st, 2014. This is the deadline when half of all container and refrigerated ships calling at California ports will be required to shut down their auxiliary engines and use electricity to power their onboard systems at berth. Known as shore power, this is the latest strategy being implemented to reduce emissions from port operations. And when you consider that shutting down auxiliary engines for just one day is the equivalent of taking 33,000 cars off the road, the impact on air quality is tremendous.
And this is a real positive result because of the health improvement that it's going to bring to the communities, the air quality improvements, actually going to be regional improvements because this stuff moves around. And so we're very, very proud to be able to turn them off. No more exhaust, and that's significant.
The Port of Long Beach was one of the first ports in the world to begin making this transition several years ago, something other ports are only beginning to consider.
As for onshore power, I think we all understand what the problems are. The port can decide to put in the equipment, but we need the shipping companies and other stakeholders to be a part of that. We are starter ports. We're nowhere as far along the path as Long Beach.
The Port of Long Beach has already converted numerous berths to be shore power accessible. Working in conjunction with terminal operators and shipping lines, the investment in shore power began before the state mandate was issued.
People have really gotten on board. We do have these shippers are very interested in doing the right thing environmentally, and people ask about it all the time. They want to go through the ports that are doing the right things like we are.
The first terminal to have shore power at the Port of Long Beach was International Transportation Services at Pier G, followed by K-Line, SSA, and Matson. In addition, British Petroleum also made the switch, making them the only operator currently in the world operating a shore power petroleum terminal.
Long Beach is really a sort of a pioneer in this. On top of that, Long Beach has also worked very closely with technology providers in trying to find interesting solutions. The solutions that you've come up with at Long Beach might be able to be adapted and implemented in places like Hong Kong.
One of the key barriers to installing shore power worldwide was having a common standard for all ports and ships to follow, as ships must call at more than one port.
Now that the ISO does have a standard for shoreside power, that removes one of the major obstacles that we had with installing it. How that is generally implemented in Hong Kong and in other ports in Asia is something that we're also thinking about quite a bit.
As other ports continue installing shore power, Long Beach will continue sharing its experience in bringing its innovative green port policy to life, yielding substantial environmental benefits to those living in Southern California.
Well, I can attest to the importance of Long Beach personally, because I think I first contacted the Port of Long Beach perhaps in 2006 or 2007. Since then, I've continued to keep a watch out what Long Beach is doing. Long Beach is the mother lode of good green port policies.
The dialogue regarding the full implementation of shore power at the Port of Long Beach continues. To find out more, visit polb.com.
The Port of Long Beach has made incredible strides over the years toward reducing emissions, and sharing this knowledge with other ports will positively impact generations to come. As you can see, we're at the maintenance division here at SSA Terminals, and when we return, we'll see how they keep these monster machines in tip-top shape.